de Griekse zangeres Savina Yannatou en haar ensemble Primavera en Salonico. En dit nummer stond op deze cd. Thank you, welcome.
Thank you.
I'm always intrigued by covers. Hmm. Was this your choice? Does it fit the music?
Yes, I think so. It is a photo of a friend of mine. Mm-hmm. So yes, it is a choice. And of course, the choice of Manfred Eicher too. We liked it both.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And does it say anything about your music? Being free?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I never thought about this. There is a nostalgia with all these birds. Uh-huh. The birds go, they return, they go and then they return. There is always this, not always with all the birds, but...
Mm-hmm. And always in search for something.
For
new food.
For food, certainly.
this song was originally an Armenian song.
Yes.
What was the original? Because you made a beautiful arrangement, or someone in your ensemble, I guess, or you? Or
Not me.
Okay.
Kostas Vomvolos, who plays the accordion and the kanun.
Okay.
Ah, the kanun,
yeah,
now. He makes the arrangements, but also after, I mean, in the rehearsals, there are things that are changed. I mean, each one of in the group can propose things, so things can change. Mm-hmm. So we are very flexible.
So you have it here in your map, so maybe you could show us.
Yes,
but this
the
is
score.
Only yes, the score.
I have just you see this. I have for years this.
In a very artistic handwriting, I must say.
Yes, is it?
Yes.
I mean, I like this, and I don't want to change it. I mean, I could have very well written all these things, but I recognize now also from the shape of the of my handwriting immediately. Even if I don't see immediately what is written, I remember it from the shape and the placing on the paper.
Where did you find it, first of all?
A friend of mine who is Armenian and he lives in Greece.
Okay.
Haik Yezidjian is his name. He is also a musician. He told me about this song. He liked it very much. And when I heard it, I liked it, me too, and I wanted to learn it. So he translated for me the lyrics. And then, of course, he showed me how to pronounce it.
Mm-hmm.
This is always a problem.
That's also a problem.
That someone has to explain you not only the translation, but also how to say the words. And if... he doesn't show it very well. You don't say it very well. It is always a risk. You have to ask more persons.
Uh-huh. It must be very difficult when you don't speak all the languages. How do you cope with that?
When I was singing only the Mediterranean songs, it was easier.
Okay. French, Italian.
Yes, it is somehow we are used to listen to these languages. Of course, there are the dialects, because we sing songs of Italy, but there are from the south of Italy, from Sicily or from Sardinia, so there are very different pronunciations. So it is not exactly the same. And of course, when we go, the Armenian is not difficult also to pronounce, but if you try to sing a song from Georgia, it is, or from Ukraine, it is difficult. From Kazakhstan, you don't understand very well how they do all these sounds. I'm sure that I cannot sing a Dutch song.
No.
It is all this horror that you do is nearly impossible for me.
And is there a sound you can do as an example?
What it's now?
Yes.
What I like?
Yes, what you like?
For example, if you listen this, I don't know if I can do it now.
No, okay.
I mean, this is a strange sound. If you listen to this for the first time, you want to see how someone can do it. What is it? It is like an instrument. Of course, now we know many people can do it. But at the beginning, when I first heard it, I said, oh, interesting. How can I do it? Or how can I use it also? And then there are other things like some areas they sing like they use the low voice a lot or very high. You can listen to whatever. I mean, if you search, I'm sorry, it's not so nice.
But you use all these sounds in your music.
Sorry?
You use all these sounds in your music.
Yes.
And that becomes you.
Finally, yes, I liked it very much. And at the beginning, I was only improvising using these sounds, free improvisation. And then when I started singing Mediterranean songs, I tried to put these elements also in the middle of these songs, even if these sounds don't come from these areas.
Okay.
But sometimes in Sardinia, for example, they use this sound, this low.
No.
So it's not so out. It is in and out.
Beautiful. You're going to do one more song for us.
Yes.
And that is it's also a mix of
Orio to Fengo from the Greek-speaking villages of the south of Italy. There are some villages where they speak Greek, the dialect of Greek, of Greece, and one song from Sicily, Terra Canun Senti, that means earth that you don't hear.
Okay, and it starts a little bit experimental, so to speak.
A little bit. We use some colors, the instruments, and the voice.
Okay. Thank you for coming and being here. Thank you.